said Yergadun Ergad Hesa Ujitan Tesapote Yakawa Karade Akwagis or Jizublale.
There's a woman, thank you, Holy Spirit. There's a woman.
Nizoko Zirae.
She never had a baby.
Isn't Takuma Dami Nerganin?
Because she wanted them for herself. Maybe, maybe not. But when she opened her mouth, her name was Hannah. She said, if you give me a child, I'll give him to you.
And see her net.
Immediately she conceived. And God, when he gives you exceedingly. Abundantly. How many of you remember Hannah? And when she said, it's not me. If you give me, I'll give you. Okay? If your wealth, there is a guy who came to our church. This guy was broke, Pastor Jonche.
But he was energetic.
He had made blocks, not blocks, bricks to sell. So many bricks to sell. Nobody was buying them. 4 years, nobody has bought them. He's cursing why he even, you know, met them. There were so many. When he came into church, and he sat there, I was preaching about something. And I told people to make a vow in relation to anything they're doing and they want a success. While seated there, Kamau said this. God, if I get a client to buy those blocks, I'll buy microphones for the church.
The
service ended, somebody called him.
I'm
bricks. He said, I have this number of bricks. So that's the number I'm looking for. When they bought them, he ran to a shop and brought microphones in church. Do you think after that God forgot him and said, now you have nothing? No, that was the beginning of Kamau. Labor with the word. Praise the Lord. Now that there is a short time for the Lord to come back. You see, I have a problem and Pastor Joseph knows it. I don't tell people to give. I just am big. Praise the Lord.
I'm
big. B-I-G. I'm big. I believe it. Praise the Lord. If you want to give, give. If you don't want to give, go home. Praise the Lord. That's how I traveled to countries of the world. That's how I went to Lusaka in Zambia. I just went. There was no money in my pocket. I just went. Money found me on the way. That's how I move. You don't do that. Seriously. If you are working with the word, there's no telling the height of your success. There's no telling. When you saw Jesus walking, and he's walking with his disciples, I'm working with the Father. And he was just walking. And they came, they told Peter, your master is broke. Ajalipa taxes.
Peter
came and told him. He told him, they are saying you've not paid taxes. He told him, do you know how to fish? Of course, you can't ask Peter, do you know how to fish?
He
told him, go and catch the first fish, okay, the one you pull out. Open his mouth and pull out money. Jesus has humor you have never seen. Pull out money from the mouth of that fish and pay for my taxes and yours, and and overpay so that they don't disturb
do
us next year.
The
Bible says he paid once, he hasn't paid again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you labor with the word, there's a young girl I found, you know, pastor knows that young girl. She's called Winnie Wanjiru. She was crying. Oh, pastor, I'm tired.
Pastor,
my husband has nothing. He comes back home with chips for our daughter. I sleep hungry. At that time, pastor was in the school of excellence. And I told the management, give this girl money every day. Give her money, transport for eating and for coming back. And I began to ask her, what do you want God to do for you? And she was just crying. You know, there are people who are just tired and they're just crying. And what do you want God to do for you? She said, I want to go back to school. I said, number one, God will do that. Number two, what do you want? She said, I want a job. I said, which one? She said, I just want a job. Because she stopped in Form 3. She said, I want a job. She kept coming to the School of Excellence. Right now, pastor knows, you know Winnie Wanjiru. She's working for Western Shuttle. She keeps all their money. She's the manager of this circle. Okay? People are complaining, how can a Form 3 sit in that office when we have graduates that have no job? When we went to Kampala, she said, next year I want to, if God can give me a car, we shall use our car. God gave her a car, the first one.
And he gave her a second one.
He gave her a third one. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Every time she comes to church, she just cries, but the tears of joy.
And she's just
telling people, the Lord is my God.
He
wants to be your God. But you have to labor with him. In any church you are in, any congregation of the Lord, labor with the Lord. Advance the gospel. There's a man who did that in the Bible. His name was Cornelius. Cornelius, chapter 10, Acts. God loved him.
What is jealousy?
There's another guy in the Bible who also built a synagogue. Okay? He wasn't a Jew. He built a church.
When
Jesus came, the Jews ran and they told Jesus, you must bless this man. He built a church. Jesus didn't say, is he a Jew? No, he just said, we did what? He built what?
He
went straight, says, take me where he is. He didn't hesitate. Because when you labor with the word, okay, that's what the Bible says, even water, when you give water to a preacher, you collect a reward. Can you imagine? How many of you know Kenneth Copeland? The man was broke. Broke is B-R-O-K-E, right? Very broke. Very broke. But when he would come to church, and they say, where's the offertory? He would even give a pencil that if he has no money, he takes a pencil and gives. Right now, there's a year when Americans were fighting. I think there was a war. And the government of America had to borrow his runway to use it in the war, in that proxy war that they were doing.
Gizebeta la America beta vitang urdom batezer. Kabeta serkali beta is mihisahalate.
Praise the Lord.
Yes?
Barabara.
O kwanza ndege sahalate. Akbeta vitasun world war sun walada.
Praise the Lord. Because he had a heart to labor with God.
He
wanted God to reach the ends. David said, send us around the world with your saving health. Send us around the world. But now he has sent you and you are still sitting on the chair. David is in the Old Testament crying, send us around the world.
But God has
told you, go ye. And you are still yawning in your chair. Hallelujah, glory to God.
Amen.
You are still yawning. God, where are you, Sikwoni? Are you serious? You know, you sing songs, Nikumbuke, you. God,
praise
the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Labor with the word.
We
are joint heirs together with Christ. We work with Christ.
I didn't
come alone. That's why I was asking who is sick. I didn't come alone. How many of you know? Let me finish. Let me say this one, then we go to heal the sick. Listen to this. How many of you know when you go to a shop and you're next to who in Kenya is? Who is Ruto or something? I think Ruto, right? If Ruto is with you, assume she's Ruto. You're not Ruto.
Yes, la Aleni Ruto.
Assume she's Ruto, and you are standing with Ruto. It tells you eat anything.
Yes, la Athini. Atu tizirat. One faith nyat.
Would you be scared?
One faith nyat sinjera nindeta.
When you find these small things, sukumawiki apa maembe, praise the Lord.
Sagale dasa.
Would you say I might pick too much? Okay.
Sumingi nte pegi Ruto nyas sinjed. Tavi taga sirelega ditistan.
That's how we have raised the dead. That's how we seen God do great things by his name. Because it's bigger than what we ever think. I tried to test him when I was a young boy. I ran from house to house looking for the sick. House to house.
Is somebody sick here?
In the name of Jesus, be healed. And the person who told me the pain is gone, I tell him you are lying. Because I was testing, okay? I could not believe it.
I didn't test it. Don't know me if I had. I don't know if I had.
And God convinced me.
What it would not do,
beyond repair. Praise the Lord.
Yani agani yani interceding kaban. What ina nabar sizet.
His presence is more real than your presence.
Yani.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
There was this preacher who used to tell me, there is one time he called me, he was somewhere in a certain place, and he told me, Pastor Roger, where are you? I want to see you. So I just jumped on, you know, I just got a picky man, I just jumped on. I didn't have any money on me, I just jumped on and we went. So when he reached there, I told him, how much do you want? I told him, give him. He looked at me and said, how did you know it's the only money I have? I told him, I don't know. You pay him first. Praise the Lord.
Of course,
those things happen once in a while, okay?
You're not giving me time.
Once in a while. Like Pastor was saying, refuse to be refused, okay? Tell somebody, I refuse to be refused.
Did you...
No, you are too weak. Tell somebody, I refuse to be
denied.
If God has accepted you, what should deny you? You know, we fear, and that's because we haven't understood right yet.
But
as the Lord tarries, in these 10 years, we are going to see great things we have never seen. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I've given you my word as positively as we are going to do what we want to do. Actually, on Thursday, because we have our meetings on Thursday. On Thursday, all those numbers, that book will be on your phone. If you have and you've registered, that book will be there. I receive grace to write it in 3 days. Because I was supposed to talk about it. Pastor told me, talk about it. But when I look at your face, you literally need the full dose. Praise the Lord.
I'm going to
immunize you.
Praise
the Lord.
Amen.
So I commit myself. I'm going to write it for you. So that you will not be deceived. Somebody say, I will not miss the first flight. And in this first, listen, we are not escaping that, oh, we may survive. No, we are living as billionaires. Do you understand? We
are living,
it is certain who will celebrate our exit. Not that we shall say, oh, to may survive. No, we're not surviving.
We are growing
because we have to go. Okay. It is written, we have to leave.
Praise the Lord.
We are not escaping. We are living by grace. Demons must celebrate our departure. If the Lord delays, it is to the disadvantage of demons. Are you getting what I'm saying? In Jesus' name. If you came weak, just stand up on you who lifted your hands, just rise up on your feet. Just come in
front of you.
Just stand across like this. And anyone who didn't lift, but there's something that you just, today, you said today is the day. Enough is enough. Okay. Enough is enough. It is for this reason we were anointed. This is why we travel the world. Not just to heal, but to heal the mind, especially. I want the rest of us to rise up on our feet. We are going to lift up our hands. You're going to lift up your hands towards them. Just lift up your hands. I can't explain what it means, but just do it for now. Just lift your hands towards them. And while your hand is lifted, just speak to the Lord. Just take your time. Just
worship
Him. In Jesus' name. And just speak to, just worship Him. Father, in the name of Jesus, every cell be healed. In Jesus' name.
Mak aye soti.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Galatu mafukul kolo.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Waka mak aye soti.
From the soles of our feet to the crown of our head,
aga yani mi vite mi kenati aga matakena Yesu Kristo di faini.
I rebuke every weakness.
Yani la fichu vindit.
I challenge every pain.
An indit lukubichu.
To live her body now.
Hadina visila kifto.
In the name of Jesus.
Maka Yesu ti.
You spell of darkness, you have gone.
Afuridu kana.
Out of her body, in the name of Jesus.
Maka Yesu ti.
Every pain is gone. Every weakness is gone. In Jesus' mighty name. By the power that raised up Jesus from the dead. I lay hands upon this beautiful baby. I command wholeness in his body. I reconstruct every cell. By the Spirit of the living God. In Jesus' name. Never again. Come out! In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. CT scan many years ago also showed that one of my lungs was gone. Okay, I have it stored somewhere. They took a CT scan of my body.
Okay.
And, I wish I knew I would have come with it. But they were lying.
Okay.
The doctor that is between me and you is saying there's no problem with your life.
Amen.
Amen. Father, thank you. In Jesus' name, appreciate the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You had pain. How do you feel? It's no longer there. Shout hallelujah. Amen. Never again. In Amen. Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Oh, Galatia.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Mama, what was wrong? Oh, you trusted God for the deliverance of the child. Somebody lift up your hands towards this woman. Father, the power that raised you from the dead. Nothing is impossible with you. Your hand is not short. We speak to this boy, to this child in Jesus' name, from the soles of his feet to the crown of his head, be made whole. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Do you stay around here? Praise the Lord. Pastor Joseph,
Pastor,
you just keep getting the testimony of this woman.
I
believe whatever God is doing is permanent in the life of this baby. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Yes, what was wrong?
Some kind of having allergies, some foods.
Oh, some foods. You eat some foods, they are funny in your body. Like what food causes allergy? Like what?
Proteins.
Do we have some proteins around here? Proteins, the food with what foods? Proteins like what? Like eggs and stuff. Like meat. Did you ate meat today? You ate. What did you feel? Any?
Sometimes, not immediately.
No, it will never come. Somebody shouted. It will never come. Father, we cast that spirit. We rebuke it from his life. We command him free and whole. From this moment forward, we command his life to be loosed.
Jesus.
And the people say amen. In Jesus' name. That thing that says it comes later, where does it come from?
Let it
remain there. Somebody say amen. In Jesus' name.
And,
everything with your body, God restores your body. In Jesus' name. One of the things I loved with my friend here, he's a brother to my to Pastor
Donce.
Somebody clap your hand, just appreciate God. You know, he said towards during lunchtime, he said, I don't normally come to Marsabit at this time of the year. But he's here, and I told him you're here for a reason. Praise the Lord. May you never forget this meeting. And somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now all of you standing, just lift up your hands toward heaven. I want you to put one hand on your body. Just put one hand and lift one hand lifted toward heaven. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, you have spoken upon this podium.
Why cannot do but?
And you have declared words upon your people. You have taught them how wealthy they are. And you continue to open the eyes of their
minds.
I challenge the demon of poverty. I
break
the bond of poverty.
In the name of Jesus. Amen.
I command you loosed. In the name of Jesus. Be free.
He come among a Christotin.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. Somebody say this prayer. Say, dear Lord Jesus. Thank you for loving me. I am free. In the name of Jesus. Whatever I do shall succeed. Whatever I touch, it shall prosper. Thank you for your presence in my life. I am a success. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Somebody clap your hands to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise Amen. The Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Listen. God loves us. God loves you. No one will ever explain how much. It is liquid love. Praise the Lord. Make these 10 years the best 10 years of your life. Let Marsabit know you exist. We are going to begin corporate fasting. I will also join in. When you do a corporate fasting, I will join in. Let us challenge the gods that have been holding back the wealth of this. How many of you believe that? I'm telling you. Do you know why Jericho's walls were closed? In chapter 5 of the book of Joshua, the angel of God, he stood before Joshua with a sword,
shifting.
And the gods of the the gods that were on in Jericho, they saw this angel. And they shut down the doors of Jericho. Because the battle was not just between Israel. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I mean,
Maleka and died. Onaka city fi had easy to gum Israeliti for Jericho and Lan in a more work at war in Jera.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Joshua had not scared them. Joshua didn't tell them, I'm coming. No, he hadn't scared them. He hadn't spoken to them. But they
Joshua
saw something.
Jericho and a woman in
yes, they saw something.
A more warrior gadget.
Not the people, literally the gods of the realm of Jericho.
Gumi Jericho sunin it work at war love some bullshitty. The Joshua were running by
the commander of heaven with Joshua.
In Argan, Yohani, Maleka, Gudawa, Kaha, Joshua, in it, our Hadugadu.
To declare the commanders of heaven, the angels, the cherubims are with you.
Malekanguak, Agudoni, Sawalinjit.
Amen. Jesus' name.
Amen.
I bless you. May God quicken you. May everywhere you go produce success. In the name of Jesus. May your children rejoice over you. May life turn around for you. May your life sprout as a morning.
In the mighty
name of Jesus. May this city rejoice because of you. For behold, when the righteous rule, the city rejoices.